Hi, this is Aaron from Cisco Defense Orchestrator, soon to be Cisco Security Cloud Control. And today, let's talk about how to get started with Cisco Defense Orchestrator. The process is very simple, and it is a complete self-service action. To get started, we're just going to go to this URL, defenseorchestrator.com/new. Now, we're going to select which region we would like our Cisco Defense Orchestrator tenant to be located. You can see the different geo regions we have available today. This video may be out of date by the time you view it, and we may have additional regions available as well. But for now, these are the regions that are available. So we'll select one, and then the next task will be to sign into the Cisco Security Cloud. If you don't already have a Cisco Cloud account, you can create one. The one caveat there is you need to use a business email address. You won't be able to use your Hotmail address or your AOL address or your CompuServe address. So you're going to need to use your corporate address to get your Cisco Cloud account established. Once that's there, it's a complete self-service process. You'll click the button. It'll take just a few minutes to spin up that Cisco Defense Orchestrator trial, and you're going to be off and running. In this series of videos, we're going to start exploring the user interface of Cisco Defense Orchestrator. So the first thing we'll do is go over to Settings and go to the General tab. And in there, we're going to scroll to the very bottom, and that's going to identify your tenant. So that'll be the details that you'll need if you ever need to reach out to support, or if you have any questions, or you need to reach out to your sales team or your vendor to talk to them about turning this trial account into a production account. By the way, there's no need to create another tenant to go production. You can simply unlock this by clicking on the upgrade to full version, entering the sales order number, which will be checked against your sales records, and turn on the paid version of Cisco Defense Orchestrator. So you can go from trial directly to production without having to redo any work. Now let's give other members of your team access to your tenant. To do that, we're going to go to Settings and Users. And here within Users, we'll see that your role is currently a super admin. A super admin is the same as an admin with the added permissions to be able to control who has access to the tenant. In other words, they can add and remove users. So let's just go ahead and add a teammate. So I'm going to add myself as an admin role. And again, the admin role cannot add or remove users, just can only admin devices in the tenant. And then we'll also create an API token. The API token, again, if you look down in the description of this video, you'll find links to our API Explorer, and you can use that API token to interact with Cisco Defense Orchestrator in an automated fashion using Python, Ansible, or Terraform, whatever your flavor happens to be. So now we've got a number of users. We have several people that can access the tenant as well as an API token. That's it for this short video on how to get started with Cisco Defense Orchestrator. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more Cisco security content. In the next video, we'll go into some common practices to set your tenant up for success for the future. So be sure to keep an eye out for that next video, and we'll see you next time.